This is Zangpo and welcome to Bhutan e-learning project. I'm Karma Dema, a teacher of Jigme Namgyel Lower Secondary School under Kimtong. I will be presenting a mathematics lesson for the key stage 3 for classes 7 and 8. The topic for today is fraction operation. Fraction. What is fraction? Do you have any idea? What are we going to do with the fraction? Do you know? Are we going to juggle the fraction? No. Are you going to bounce the fraction? No. So what are we going to do with the fraction? We are going to learn addition, subtraction of fraction. Then also we are going to learn multiplication and division of fraction. We will start with addition of fraction. Let's look at adding fractions using model. For example, we will add 2/3 and 1/5. We will use the model. We got 3 rows and 5 columns. Now we are going to present 2/3 on the grid. We already filled 2/3 of the grid. And can you count how many grids are filled? Okay, let's count together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so how many grids are filled? So it is 10 out of 15 are filled. That means 10/15 is equivalent to 2/3. Now we will present 1/5. Out of 5 columns, we filled just 1 column. And how many grids can you see there? Okay, how many grids? Let's count together. 1, 2, 3. Okay, 3 grids out of 15 are filled. That means 3/15 is an equivalent fraction of 1/5. Now children, we filled in 2/3 and we filled in 1/5 of the fraction. Now let's put together 2/3 and 1/5 and see how many grids do we get. Okay. Now children, all of you see carefully and can you count the grids which are filled? Okay, let's count together. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So 13 grids are filled. So that means when we add 2/3 and 1/5, we get 13 over 15. See children, is it very interesting? Yes, you will enjoy it. So let's move forward without using model. To add 3/4 and 4/5, we will make same denominator. So we will find the LCM of the denominator of the given fraction, that is 4 and 5. So to find the LCM of 4 and 5, first we have to list all the multiples of 4 and list all the multiples of 5. Multiples of 4 are 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, and so on. Now look at multiples of 5. We have 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, and so on. We have to look for the lowest common multiple. What is the lowest common multiple of 4 and 5? Lowest common multiple of 4 and 5 is 20. As the LCM of 4 and 5 is 20, we are going to find equivalent fraction of 3/4 and 4/5 by making the denominator 20. Let's find out the equivalent fraction for 3/4. 4 how many times is 20? 4 times 5 is 20. You again have to multiply the numerator with the same number which you multiply with the denominator, and we use 5 down there. So 3 times 5, again we get 15. So 15 over 20 is equivalent to 3 over 4. Now we will find out for 4/5. So again, 5 how many times is 20? 5 times 4 is 20. That means 4 times 4 is 16. That means 16 over 20 is an equivalent fraction of 4/5. Now we already got the equivalent fraction of the given fraction down there. Now what should we do? Do you know what should we do? Yes, we have to add the numerators and denominator will be same. Now after adding the numerators, we got 31 over 20. Now look at the answer here. 31 over 20. What do you think? It is an improper fraction. As our answer is improper fraction, we have to convert it into mixed number. When we convert it, we get 111 over 20. Now let's move our lesson forward by subtracting using models. Now again, we have an example here. We are going to take away 2/3 from 3/4. How many rows are filled? Okay, we filled in 3 rows. So how many counters can you see? So can we count together? Okay, let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have 9 counters in the grid. That means 9 out of 12 is an equivalent fraction of 3/4. Now from 3/4, we have to take away 2/3. So can you take away 2/3? Is it possible right now? No, we have to make some adjustment. To make 2/3 or take away 2/3, first we have to make 2/3 in the grid model. So let's bring the counters and fill in the empty space. Now we got 2/3 here. Now you can easily take away 2/3. Now we will take away 2/3. After taking away 2/3, how many counters can you see on the grid, children? Okay, we can see only one counter there. So what is the answer? It is 1/12. So when you take away 2/3 from 3/4, our answer is 1/12. Subtracting fractions without using model. Now we have a fraction here. So it is 3/4 minus 2/3. Again, we are going to take 2/3 from 3/4. We will have to find LCM, just like what we did with the addition of the fraction. What is the LCM of 4 and 3? The LCM of 4 and 3 is 12. Now 12 will be the common denominator for 4 and 3. The equivalent fraction of 3/4 is equals to 9 over 12, and equivalent fraction of 2 over 3 is equals to 8 over 12. And when we subtract the numerators, we get 1 and the denominator will remain the same. Multiplying and dividing fractions. Now you know, children, always multiplying and dividing fraction, they go together. They get along so well together, and let's say they are best of friends. So we will first start with the multiplying of fraction. And remember, children, multiplying fraction is super easy, and in fact it is much easier than adding fractions. So look at it. So first we will multiply fraction with whole number. And we have example here, 2 times half. Okay, 2 times half. It means half is added 2 times. We are using repeated addition here, as the multiplication is the shorter way to represent repeated addition. Half plus half equals to 1 whole. Therefore, 2 times half equals to 1. Similarly, we will multiply 3 times 1/4. It means 1/4 is added 3 times. So let's see, children, using the models. 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4 equals to 3/4. That means when we put all 1/4 together, how many fourths do we get? Okay, how many fourths do we get? Yes, we get 3/4. 3 times 1/4, it is equals to 3/4. Just a reminder or a note for what we have already done. When a fraction is multiplied by a whole number, the numerator is multiplied by the whole number and the denominator remains the same. As we are multiplying 3 times 1/5, so 3 is the whole number there and 1 is the numerator of the fraction. So we will multiply whole number with the numerator and the denominator remains the same. So we get 3 over 5. Let's look at another example, that is 4 times 1/7. So same thing here, 4 is the whole number, 1 is the numerator of the fraction. We will multiply numerator and the whole number and the denominator remains the same and our answer is 4/7. Okay children, now we are going to multiply a fraction by a fraction which is little bit different than what we did before. Now we have example here, 2/5 times 5/6. Here to show this or how to go about this, we will use model. We have 5 rows here. So out of 5 rows, we are going to shade 2 rows. Okay, 1, 2, that means 2/5 times 5/6. Out of 6 columns, we are going to shade 5 columns. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it shows it is 5/6. Now equals to, how many common shaded grids can you see up? Can we count together? Yes, let's count together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes, we got 10 out of 30. That means when we multiply 2/5 times 5/6, our answer is 10 over 30. When two fractions are multiplied together, the two numerators are multiplied together and the two denominators are multiplied together and they are written as an equivalent fraction. For example, we have 4/7 is being multiplied to 1/7. Now we are going to multiply numerators and numerators, which is 4 times 1. And we are going to multiply denominators by denominator, which is 7 times 7. Now we get 4 over 49. Dividing a fraction by a whole number. We have a situation here. The situation is a recipe for 4 people require 2/3 cup of a rice. How much rice is required for 1 person? We will use the model to find out how much rice is required by 1 person. So to find out, I have 1 hole here and 1 hole has been divided into 3 parts. Out of 3 parts, 2/3 are shaded. We got 2/3 here. How do we divide among 4? To divide 2/3 by 4, we have to divide each 1/3 into 4 equal parts. After dividing each 1/3 into 4 equal parts, how many parts do we get? Can we count together? Let's count together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We got 12 parts. Out of 12 parts, how many shaded parts can you see? Let's count that shaded part. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 parts are shaded out of 12. Now, we already got 8, 12. That means we can easily divide among 4 people. Now, let's see how much rice each people get. Okay, 1, 2, the first person. Again, 2, 12 taken by second person. Again, 2, 12 taken by the third person. And the last 2, 12 taken by the fourth person. By looking at the diagram only, we know that when we divide 2/3 among 4 people, each person will get 2/12 cup of rice. Now, let's read together what we have already done. When a fraction is divided by a whole number, it is same as multiplying denominator by the whole number, keeping the numerator as it is. Here, we are not going to change the numerator. It will remain the same, but we are going to use the whole number to multiply with the denominator. So, let's see here. 2/3, when we divide by 4, it is shown as 2/3 times 1/4, which is equals to 2/12. Look at this. 2/3 divided by 4 is equals to 2/3 times 1/4, right? 1/4. We can see 4 written as 1/4. Can you see 4 written as 1/4? Now, in other words, this is called reciprocal, or in other words, we are using reciprocal. Now, when I say reciprocal, what is reciprocal? Reciprocal is just flipping over. What did I say? Reciprocal is just flipping over. Now, let's look at the example here. Number 5, when we write as fraction, we will write 5 over 1. And the reciprocal of 5 over 1 is 1 over 5. Similarly, whole number 8 written as fraction 8 over 1, and reciprocal of 8 over 1 is 1 over 8. And the same thing applies down there. 1000 written as 1000 over 1, reciprocal of 1000 over 1 is 1 over 1000. So, we will look at one more example here. 3/5 divided by 3. Okay, now here we have to write the reciprocal from form of whole number 3. What is the reciprocal of 3? Can you say? Yes, it is 1/3. The reciprocal of 3 is 1/3. So, we will write as 3/5 times 1/3, which gives us 3 over 15, dividing fraction by fraction. Now here, we are not going to use models, as we have already done so many models and it must be in your mind now. So here we will use reciprocal. Now let's see, we have 2/5 divided by 3 times. What is the question? 2/5 divided by 3 times. Now, which fraction are you going to reciprocal? What? Okay, 3 over 10. Yes, 3 over 10 we are going to reciprocal. So, what is the reciprocal of 3 over 10? Okay, it is 10 over 3. The reciprocal of 3 over 10 is 10 over 3. Now, we got the reciprocal. Now, what should we do here? Now, we have to multiply numerators, all the numerators together, and we have to multiply all the denominators together. When we multiply numerators together, that is 2 times 10, we get 20. And when we multiply denominators together, we get 15. That is 5 times 3 is 15. Now, look at the answer. What do you think? Is it a proper fraction? Is it a mixed number? Yes, it is an improper fraction. When the answer is improper fraction, what should we do? we have to convert improper fraction into mixed number by dividing numerator by denominator, and we get 1/5/15. Now we got the answer as mixed fraction, that is 1/5/15. Now you just forget about the whole number here. You just look at the numerators and the denominators. What do you think? Do you think these two numbers have the common factor? Do you think? Yes, we know they have the common factor. Now what could be the common factor of 5 and 15? Yes, it is 5. So 5 divided by 5 we get 1. 15 divided by 5 we get 3. So answer in lowest term is 1/3. Let's look at dividing mixed number. Now we have a question here. 8/3/4 is divided by 1/1/4. That means how many 1/1/4 are there in 8/3/4? Here we will use a different model. We will use a number line here. So let's look at the number line. Here we have a number line and it starts from 0 till 9. Now on this number line, let's mark 8/3/4. Okay, so here it is 8/3/4. Now, as we are going to see how many 1/1/4 are there in 8/3/4, first we have to see where 1/1/4 is on number line. So let's find out. Okay, here it is 1/1/4. So it makes one jump of 1/1/4. So let's count the jump together, children. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, how many jumps? We make 7 jumps. That means there are 7 1/1/4 in 8/3/4. So when we divide 8/3/4 by 1/1/4, the answer is 7. So see, using the number line, we can easily divide the mixed numbers. So further you can explore it. Now again, I will give you another example using reciprocal. Our fraction here is a mixed fraction. We cannot directly reciprocal it. First, we have to convert the mixed fraction into improper fraction. Now, to convert mixed fraction into improper fraction, multiply the denominator of the fraction part by the whole number and then add the result to the numerator. We have 8/3/4, which is a mixed number here. So to convert this mixed number into improper fraction, 8 is the whole number here and 4 is the denominator. So we will multiply 8 times 4, then add 3, which is numerator, and denominator will remain same. When we multiply 8 times 4 plus 3, we get 35 out of 4. So 35 out of 4 is equivalent fraction of 8/3/4, or we can say it is an improper fraction of 8/3/4. Now similarly, look at 1/1/4. As 1 is the whole number there and 4 is the denominator, let's multiply 1 times 4, then add 1, which is numerator, and we get 5/4. Improper fraction of 8/3/4 is 35/4, and improper fraction of 1/1/4 is 5/4. So here we have to look at the reciprocal of 5/4. So what will be the reciprocal of 5/4? Reciprocal of 5/4 is 4/4. 5. Now, what should we do here? We have to multiply numerators and numerators, denominators by denominators. When we multiply 35 times 4, we get 140. And when we multiply 4 times 5, we get 20. So our answer is 7. That means there are 7 1 1 4 in 8 3 over 4. Children, I hope you all enjoyed my video lesson. Thank you and Tesh Dele. See you in the next lesson.